straight edges for this bucket here. I tried it. I've had good luck with the aftermarket ones, and anyway, I'm trying to get those. Nobody's got them aftermarket wise. Cat has them, but holy crap, are they expensive. The ones that are on here are aftermarket. I put several thousand hours on them without any problems. I'm trying to go that way, but I'm in desperate need. And the aftermarket ones are 4 days out. I may just have to bite the bullet. Go that route, I don't know. I tell you what, I've spent so much money on, you know, fortunately nothing major repair-wise, but just, you know, a little $500, $600, $700, $1200 this year seems like. Taking it easy and not been kind of trying to take it easy and not break these off, because they're a pain in the butt to get out.
All right, guys, good Sunday morning. I'm actually back out here. You can, where I was pushing all these trees and stuff up and, you know, going in between the mature oaks and stuff and clearing all the brush and the crap out. Anyway, I'm back out here because the other day, and it's been, it's been a week or so since I was out here, and you remember it being real super dusty and everything. But anyway, I'm out here to pick up the loader because I just happened to discover this, which is a good thing that I did. I just happened to discover this the day that I parked it out here. And it's I'm very fortunate in the fact that I did discover it, because had I not discovered it, it would have been catastrophic, because I've actually seen this happen before. And if you've been following me on Instagram, and that's at DirtDaddy953, then you've seen these pictures. But anyway, here we go. I don't know if you can see this crack right here. This crack goes all the way. Let's see if I can get down without breaking my neck. This crack goes all the way from here. It goes all the way around. You can see it's splitting up here. It goes all the way around the weld. And it is all the way down to here, right here. You can see where my finger's at. So the weld is cracked. It cracked around the weld here. It's not made it any further, and I'm pretty sure it's not cracked on the other side. And I've looked over here, and I don't think this one's cracked. I can't see where this one's cracked. But if you'll notice how much more material's here and all around here, because of the return to dig system is hooked here. So there's a lot more material around here than there is on this other side. See here? There's not much material past the pin boss. See that other one? The other side comes way up like this and down. That, my friends, is a bad design. I mean, Kat, I love you to death, but what the hell were you thinking on that? And I have always thought that is, because that's not half inch. That's less than half inch steel. So, I mean, seriously, and I hope we ain't got anything else going. It's gonna be gun shy. But anyway, you see what I'm saying? So now the cab has to come off and probably the loader L will have to come off so he can get in and air arc that out and then weld it up and then plate it. So, like I said, again, look at here, right here, and then we'll go over here and look at this other side. See here, that side, it's almost even with the weld. see how much more material we have here, even above on the top. You know, there's almost 3 inches more material on the top on this side than there is on that side. And I actually seen one of a C model in our local cat dealership. It's been a year or two ago, and the guy didn't catch it and had a full bucket load of dirt raised up, getting ready to load it in a dump truck, and this pin boss and everything pulled out. And when it pulled out, the loader went like this and fell on the ground, which wiped the cylinders out. And I can't remember, I think it wiped all 3 cylinders out. A tilt cylinder, both lift cylinders, pulled this all out. And then on the other side, the loader arm, it took and bent it in a 90 where it came around. So, like I said, it came around, and when it did, it bent this portion in a 90. So they were lucky enough to find a used set of loader assembly. They just put his bucket and everything back on it, but they were lucky enough to find that, a used one. But it was, I think they said it was going to be a $25,000 repair or something like that. So anyway, why in the heck wasn't they thinking, and why would they not go ahead and bring this out and down? I mean, up here, come out and around all the way up to here, or laminate this, put another plate like we're gonna do, put another plate around this and weld it. I mean, come on. So anyway, I've been cleaning ponds out again, but so this one's down for a while. I've got to take it, and like I said, that's where I'm taking it now, dropping it off. So anyway, it can be repaired, because I need it to get this job finished here, and I don't lack a whole lot. It's just I take this little fence row out here, and then those sparse hedge trees out in that field, you know, just one every now and then, take them out and pile all them up. But anyway, so my client here, he wants me to use a loader. He doesn't want me to use the excavator or anything like that, and that's fine. That's 100% his choice. So that's what we're gonna do. I'm just gonna go ahead and take this over. I think in a couple days getting it fixed. And then I'll keep working on ponds until it's fixed, and come back over and get her finished up. So anyway, just a quick update on that. And I'll try to have the mechanic go ahead and take pictures as he's going through stages on this. So anyway, so this will be on the tail end of the last video. When I was finishing this up, I'll just attach it to the tail end. So I was gonna put new cutting edges on all the way, and new corner shanks. You can see those are wore out, but bigger fish to fry right now. So anyway, we'll check in with you later.